Welcome to our virtual Christmas concert fundraiser. Now, introducing Doris Hall James.
To the Indie Show. It is such a pleasure this evening to see all of you. I'd like to thank all of you out there for your support and dedication to our cause of helping entertainers and children have a better holiday season. Special thanks goes out to all the performers tonight because, boy, you have worked hard. You have practiced and practiced and practiced. And I just want to thank you for what you've done. Special thanks also goes out to Pamela Renee Smith, Shirley Lights, Andrea Jackson, Mimi Brown, and Shauna Hall for all of their hard work and effort in putting this concert together. So sit back and relax as Simply Music Incorporated, Philadelphia Musician Lives Matter, NABFEME and AMJ Entertainment brings to you our Christmas concert. Now, don't forget to donate. Now, our host for this evening is the lovely and talented Philadelphia's own WDAS-FM personality, Miss Mimi Brown. But before I bring on Mimi, I want to say a couple of things about Mimi. Mimi is such a great, dynamic person. When she was asked to host the Christmas concert, she accepted right away, stating, I love this and I want to be a part. And we want you to be a part, Mimi. So I want to say thank you. Over 40 years in the radio. Once again, Facebook, ladies and gentlemen, I introduce Miss Mimi Brown.
Love you so much, Doris Hall James. You certainly are amazing and look so beautiful tonight. It's so exciting to be with each and every one for our Christmas concert because musicians' lives matter. I think that this year, 2020, has never been anything like I have ever experienced or even you. We pray for those that we have lost due to COVID-19. Yes. We pray that for anybody that's been affected by this pandemic, because all of our lives have been touched differently. We come to you virtually because it's the only way that we can reach you. It's the only way that we can touch you, and we know what music does, and musicians are the ones that nobody thinks about. During the course of this pandemic, if the musicians are the last on the list, I've never heard anybody say, what about the musicians? Is there a fund for them? Can we take care of them? Can we look out? But meanwhile, there's a song that got you through the hard times. There's a song that brought marriages, and there's a song that brought a child into this world, and with those songs and those musicians, we're going to honor them today. The first first one we'd like to honor is Professor Randy J. Gibson. He is the founder of the Gibson School of Music and Arts that offers classes in music and dance, voice and drama, also instruments. Now, it's a place where virtually every instrument is taught from ages of all different ages. It's located right in Philadelphia at 5425 North 5th Street, Philadelphia, PA 19120. Now, Professor Gibson has conducted over 100 classes and taught over 5,000 students. Tonight, for your listening pleasure, he will perform for you a piano solo, Oh, Holy Night, Professor Gibson. Thank you. Wow. Wow. Professor Gibson, you are absolutely amazing. What is it like to teach 5,000 students?
Well, over the years, it's certainly been more than that. We've been in teaching at this school for 25 years, and all the students have done wonderful things. It's something you said earlier, which I say all the time. Music, we use the left hemisphere and the right hemisphere of our brain, and it helps the students in math, the sciences, and you're right, because in our everyday language, you only use one side of your hemisphere, so very perceptive of you to say that. But in teaching the many students, the many experiences, it just helps the students to navigate through life.
Tell us about what we've been going through right now with the pandemic. How have you been able to be in touch with your students, or are you able to during this time?
Yes, we are in touch virtually and through Zoom. And this, like you said, is still a place for music in all of our aspects of our life and all of the arts. I have an environmental project that's coming out tomorrow called the Taconi Creek Suite, in which we compose music dealing with the Taconi Creek and a watershed. And it's an environmental type of ecological thing. And so it forces you to dig deep within yourself and around you. When you're dealing with a pandemic, you're not just taking a shot or a pill, but you have to deal with the environment around you. And by them cleaning up this creek environmentally, it's going to also enhance the way we live.
I absolutely am so enthused about this project that you're doing, because it affects each and every one of us. Water. Yes. We cannot exist without water. Now, we can go days without food, but not without water.
There you go. Water is life.
Water
is life. I want to make sure you get a copy of this project called the Taconi Creek Suite. As I was composing this, it took about a year and a half to compose. In the midst of it, I said, I can't. All the songs have dual meanings, like Wings as Eagles deals with the ornithology also, but it deals with Isaiah 40, 31. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Mm-hmm. And also one particular song I had to add, it's called Live Stream 846. Mm-hmm. 846 should mean a lot to people. 8 minutes and 46 seconds. It dealt with the death of Mr. George Floyd, and it's a saxophone and piano, very poignant piece that we had to add, dealing with the all the things that we're dealing with. We're still dealing with political, racial unrest and among people, and we can't just live our lives without not dealing with these aspects in our music and in our arts. So look for that one. I hope to also be able to get that to the family, actually, of Mr. George Floyd. But all the songs have dual meanings. But we also relate to the environment, the ecological aspect, and relate to our everyday life. So it's a song on there called Moment of Silence. In our daily lives, when we think of a moment of silence, you usually think of death, but we need a moment each day. We thank God for waking up, but we need to just take a moment. If you woke up today or tomorrow, you need to take a moment just to thank God and understand what assignment He has for you for this particular day. One day at a time.
One day at a time. You certainly have enhanced our day by your beautiful music. Thank you for all that you have done and all that you continue to do. Professor Randy J. Gibson, as we continue with our Christmas concert, because musicians' lives matter. And you know, when it comes to Christmas, we think about things that we used to do, which is the gathering of family, making cookies. Yeah, I know we used to always make cookies, and I always used to put something out for Santa until one year Santa forgot to eat the cookies. And I became aware about some things that were going on. What is Christmas? But one thing that is essentially Christmas is music. And Denise Montana has brought us a Christmas song that has gone on for year after year after year. It's a part of our lives. Denise Montana, platinum recording artist Denise Montana. She is a vocalist who traces her roots not only from jazz and blues, but also from the great American songbook standards to disco. We remember her during the disco days. I know that I do and absolutely loved him. Denise has sold millions of recordings, including her double platinum song, Merry Christmas All, on South Soul Records. She will make an appearance to say a few words, and a video will play afterwards. Here we go, Denise Montana.
Hello, everyone. My name is Denise Montana. You may recognize me from number one DJ, Merry Christmas All, and my jazz CD, In My Life. I want to say happy holidays, happy new year to all. Let's continue to share the love. Welcome to this Christmas concert. You will love everyone that is on board tonight. Have peace. Enjoy the new year coming up, 2021. I hope that we have lots of health and wealth. And oh, please donate to Simply Music, Inc. Many blessings.
Denise Montana, thank you.
Happy, jolly,
Montana with Merry Christmas all. We did get some snow this week, so it's certainly relatable when we see that video. And this is not the night for you to go out. This is the night for you to stay in and join us for our Christmas concert, because musicians' lives matter. And don't forget to donate. You can see the information right below on the page. You can go to Cash App by giving the $ Simply Music with the number 1. And also, you can do the donate button on simplymusicinc.com. I'm Mimi Brown as we continue with Theodore Life. Theodore Life is famous all over the world. He's better known as T-Life. He is a musician. He is a songwriter, a producer. His songs and guitar licks can be found on various Philadelphia International Records, along with Gamblin' and Huff. You know that T-Life has co-produced Evelyn Champagne King's Shame, Million Seller Shame. Ladies and gentlemen, to speak with us tonight, T-Life.
Hey, T, where are you? We're waiting for you. Well, you know what? While we're waiting for tea, I'm going to say one thing. Mimi, I remember when I used to go out and dance, and I would dance. I still do it every now and then, you know?
Yes.
My favorite song to dance on was that Shame. When you put that song on, Mimi,
yes,
I would dance. Okay, yes. You know, I would do some twirls. I would do some dips. I would do some vocal stuff. You know, I was really, really in it. You know, I
loved it. So was I. I'm going to tell you the same thing with me. Absolutely loved it.
Yes.
And then when they gave us the long extended version, you remember the disco version?
Yes.
And they gave us like 7 minutes, 7 or 8 minutes of Shame. We worked it. Sweat would be pouring off of me.
Yes!
One of the best dance songs ever.
And I know right now, Mimi, right now, you know how in Philadelphia we have block parties all the time in the summer, except for this year, but we had block parties, and they would put that song on, bam, I was right out in the street, okay? dancing. So I want to thank John Fitch, who was one of the writers, Ruben Cross. I want to thank T. Light, who was producer. I want to thank you for playing that song and letting
played it in the clubs first before I even got to radio. We played it in the club. Loved it.
Yes, it was a great song. So if we can hear while we're waiting for T. Light, can we hear a part of Shame? Can we, Shauna? What do you think? I don't know if we can or not. When you mention Shame, T. Life, he just bubbles. He just bubbles.
Okay. Yeah, he really does. Do you want to go to Whittington?
Well, yes. Let's see if we can go to Whittington. Just hold on 1 second.
You know, as we come to you live, this is live, and I just want to thank everybody who's joining us on Facebook Live. And this is our Christmas concert. We have so many artists that are going to perform today, including Shirley Lights, and also those that want to speak to you, because musicians' lives matter. Even during the pandemic, nobody has spoken about what musicians are going through. The musicians who worked in the studio on the artists that we love, whether it's Teddy Pendergrass or Patti LaBelle or Dexter Wanzel, and then we can go on and on. And of the artists, whether you like P. Diddy or Rihanna, or you like Drake, or you like Usher, or you like Chris Brown, no matter what your artist is and what your flavor is, there's no musician that can play their music right now. And you cannot see the concert, whether it's a Cardi B, you cannot see her in concert. You cannot see Megan Thee Stallion in concert, because there are no concerts right now. And what we have gone through with musicians, nobody has addressed. Do they get a check at the end of the week that they say that they are able to get money from? No. So they can get money back? And so musicians have really had a difficult time. And that's why we're doing this. Please donate what you can. No gift is too small. Believe me, if 100 people gave $5, that's $500. Yes. That can help somebody. Yes. That's all. Just donate what you can. Right, Doris?
That's right. And we prepare care gift packages, and we send out to musicians who, you know, who are in need, who's been sick, who's been in the hospital. We do all that kind of stuff. And we take care of the kids at Christmas time. We send out packages to them. We do a whole lot of good stuff for musicians and a whole lot of good stuff for the kids. And therefore, we need your support. We need your support to help us, to enable us to continue doing all the good things that we do as Simply Music and as Philadelphia Music, Musician Lives Matter, and NABFEME. We need, and AMJ Entertainment, we need all your support. We got together, all four organizations, and we say, hey, y'all, we're going to do it. And this is what we're going to do. I think T-Life. On his way in, so could we just wait for him 1 second? Okay.
Yes. Yeah. You know, give us some more information about, you know, where we can go to in order to donate. They can donate through what sources?
Okay, they can go to the website simplymusicinc.com and donate, or they can donate through Cash App. That's the $ SimplyMusic1. They can donate, or we have a fund me page on Facebook. They can donate then by going to DHJ Indie Show on my page and donating from there.
Yeah. Okay. That's pretty awesome. I just think, you know, even if it's a dollar, you know, give what you can. Even if it's like $5, you know,
every dime counts.
And I know all of us are going through hard times, but I truly believe that when you give, it always comes back. No matter what, it always comes back. When you give a sandwich. You know what? You get a refrigerator full of food. You'll say, who dropped off these groceries? You know, it's because that is basically how the universe works.
Yeah.
You know, we're here for a reason and certainly for a purpose. And a part, I truly do believe that we are here as givers of knowledge, the sharers of knowledge, the sharers of love, and continue to give what it is that you can. It's very difficult to walk past someone that you know is having a hard time and not say, would you like a cup of coffee? Can I get you some tea? Would you like a cup of soup? You know, and if you've done that, I know that you felt it in your gut and said, I should have gone back, you know, but it opens up your awareness to give you another opportunity. I always believe it's a second opportunity in order for you to help someone that's in need. And whether you do it or not, it's completely up to you. We do have our own choice.
Yeah.
We all make our choices. And we asked all of you to make a choice tonight and help musicians, because musicians' lives matter.
Please donate. Please donate. You know, donate to us.
And there's so many musicians that, there's Mr. Handsome himself right there.
Is that him?
That's the one and only, you know.
All right.
T don't come unless T is right. All right, and you are right tonight, T Light.
Throw money.
Wait a minute, I gotta get my dollar bill. Let me get dollar bill. I have a stack here. That's about all.
Hi, ladies.
Dollar bills. Hello. How are you?
Hi, ladies. How are you?
How are you?
Oh, darling, I'm truly wonderful and amazing right about now.
You know, it's just so great to be able to talk to you. Talk to us, T-Life. This has been a pandemic in a musician's life. What is this like? It has been for you? And what would you like to convey to individuals out there who don't have a clear understanding of what musicians are going through right now?
Well, you know, I got to say this. You know, I heard a lot of people talking about stuff like that. And everything was, and you know, we have the melanin, especially black people, you know, and we're not susceptible to catching the virus. That ain't true. Trust me. The mask is the only thing that they had. It was the only weapon that we had, that and some stuff on your hands and put stuff on your feet and, you know, to try to rid ourselves of the germ itself. So, but that's not true about us being the, you know, not being able to catch this virus. I'm getting over it myself and my wife.
Wow, baby.
And our house is like a hospital, man. You know, the gloves, the mask. You can't come in my house unless you got a mask and gloves on. We even got the thing for your feet, you know.
Like just like the hospital.
Yeah. So yeah. How did we, people say, well, where'd you get it at? We don't know. We really, truly don't know. It's airborne, but the mask and, you know, all of that stuff is the only line of defense that we've had against this virus, you know. But thank God, I mean, we've been in quarantine. We were in quarantine for about 4 weeks.
Wow, too late.
We chose that fourth week just to make sure we were cool, you know.
Yes, yes.
It's a very, very dangerous, and it's killing people. And I'm going to tell you something. Yeah. Hope the young people are listening to this. Mm-hmm. I've seen a lot of young people in there in wheelchairs.
Mm.
Go there, trust me. Mm. Wheelchairs and their parents with them. And some of these children are not really children, but they're children to their parents. You're talking 30 and 40 year olds. I'm not talking 16, 18, 20. Okay. Give you a little, you know, I'm a senior. Like that, senor. You know, I didn't see any senors and senoritas.
Yeah, and I'm a senorita.
Definitely a senorita.
Senorita.
Ah, yeah, but you're a senorita Rita.
No question about it. Hey, more bien.
You know, so I just wanted to get that out there. This is something that's really, Doris is my good friend and I love her. She's doing a beautiful thing for the musicians in Philadelphia. But I had something else I wanted to talk about.
Yeah.
And that was about the R&B music.
Mm-hmm.
R&B is becoming extinct. I want that word to ring a little bit, extinct. You know, I don't mind, you know, copying is a flattery, is a form of flattery when people do your thing, you know. It's all well and cool. And different genres and different races of people are doing R&B. I've been here for quite a while on this planet. I do it all. I've done all types of music, you know. But I've never seen a generation without R&B. It has always been R&B and blues, always, always revered, copied, imitated, you know, some of the biggest artists in the world have covered a lot of R&B. So it is a part of American and European history. I got to say European, because the Europeans love R&B. You understand what I'm saying? People in America love R&B, but you know, what has happened, and I want to get this out there so we all know what I'm talking about, it's becoming extinct. It's becoming extinct because of big corporations have come in and did what they had to do and bought up all the unnecessary things that they needed to do to control. And they're only going to play what they want. You know what I'm saying? They want to be heard. But we have to do right now, since this is here we are getting a handout. I mean, I hate to say that. What are we doing? Can we help R&B? If we're not careful, this is going to be extinct. It's going to be shut down like jazz or any other rest of the musics, you know? And so I just wanted to get that out there, and I know we don't have enough time, but Mimi, I love you. I've known you for many, many years, and the last time I saw you was at our friend Buddy D's home going.
Yes, T-Life. Yeah. What a sad, That was, I was so happy to see everyone, but Buddy D has really changed the lives of so many musicians by being such a hard worker, and I absolutely miss him so much. His son Troy and also his beautiful wife Gail, we send our love out to them during this holiday season. And
I love Buddy, man. I used to have questions to ask, and I said, let me call Buddy. Or, you know, and it was really, really funny that day. I went to Catholic school. Hadn't been to church in a long, long time. And man, the whole thing was changed. And I was sitting up there going, hey, the benediction is not like that. She turned around, she's looking, and who else was there? Would Lady B there?
But yeah, I'm sure Lady B was there.
It was freaking me out, man.
Linda Penn was there.
Yeah.
All the promotion men were there.
All the
Billy Hendricks was there. I mean, you just saw people that you haven't seen in so many years. Musicians were there. Everyone paid homage to Buddy D. I met Morris Day through Buddy D. He brought Morris Day. He brought him in. He said, Mimi, he said, you're not leaving the radio at 12 o'clock, are you? That's when I was doing, I was working from 7 until midnight. And I said, yeah, I'm leaving at 12. Hold on. Don't go anywhere. And he brought in Morris Day for me to interview. I was like, this is phenomenal. I'll stick around for Morris Day. No problem.
He was a piece of work. But at any rate, great. Hope that this turns out real good. I'm sure it is. And that's all we got. I mean, we have a short segment here. Wouldn't they give us 4 minutes?
We have a short segment because there are other people that have to speak. But other than that, we're going to have to do this again so that we can not only hear your music, but let you talk about it. And also at the same time, let us expound on some things that all of us need to do to make it better for musicians.
Absolutely.
Artists, songwriters, producers.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. It needs to be talked about. Something needs to be done. I have friends that want to do something to take the R&B music and to help it not be extinct.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
With every generation, there's change.
There is.
You know, and the young people got to have. I know I had to have. I didn't trust nobody over 30.
Yes.
He wasn't listening to Jimi Hendrix or James Brown.
You sound like me.
You know what I'm saying?
You know, because I couldn't understand people who didn't understand Jimi Hendrix. It's like, you don't listen to Jimi Hendrix? Are you just are you just listening to the Jackson 5? Have you heard Jimi Hendrix? Have you heard him? He's playing musically. Once they got into it, their mind was blown.
But them not even knowing that he played guitar with the Isley Brothers
and Tom Ernie.
You know what I'm saying?
He was
me, man. All of this stuff.
But I still have some questions about the whole Jimi Hendrix thing, but I could talk to you about that privately. Just don't want to put it out there publicly, but gone too soon. That's all I can say publicly,
and people need to know.
Well, you know, it's just a thought.
No. I'm only kidding. Only I could do that on my own.
Yeah, you could see T like
I
you
can't have Mimi Brown doing that.
No, don't go there, T. Like, don't go there. You can do this on your own. But to speak with you, you are a survivor of COVID-19, your entire family. My prayers go out to you and your family for what it is that you've been through and that you're able to share today with us and stand here. Not everybody can stand here and talk about it, but you can talk about it. And then you have your wits about you, your style about you, your look is not gone. You're all together, all pulled together, and you're ready to keep moving forward. Thank you so much for joining us on our Christmas concert tonight. It means so much.
Thank you. I really appreciate it. And please give, everybody.
Give T-Life. You are amazing. Thank you, T-Life. Bless you. Happy holidays.
Okay, happy holidays.
He brought us Shame, but he brought us a whole lot of songs, a whole lot of records, and also brought us some knowledge tonight, the one and only T Life. Right now, we'd like to go to Whittington Steele, vocalist and songwriter, actress, is sharing her growth and her accomplishments with the world. Now, she's supported by the Steele Standing Productions, which is an umbrella for her music. Whittington's song, The Christmas Song, will be performing Chestnuts Roasting. And so we'd like to go to you, Whittington Steele.
Hello and Merry Christmas. How is everyone? I hope everyone is well. So I am going to sing the Christmas song by Nat King Cole's version. I hope everyone can hear me okay. Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost sniffing at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tying tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you. This season has become one of my favorite seasons. It's the spirit of giving, the spirit of sharing, and everyone being so kind, as it should be. So, yeah, it's my favorite season. And so, I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you. Merry Christmas.
You sound so beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
Whittington Steele, you are absolutely amazing. You gave us one of the most favorite songs of all time.
And I'm so happy you're here, Mimi. How are you?
I'm fine, my gorgeous. And look at your microphone. That is so classic.
Of a Nat King Cole, a classic
of an Etta James. You know what I'm saying? And
yeah.
when it comes to you as a singer, songwriter, you know we've been through a difficult time. Any advice that you would have for those that are in a situation where it's very difficult for them to get through this pandemic? And what would you like to offer them in terms of your support and encouragement?
Well, thank you for asking me that, because there are so many opportunities right now. While you're home, take this time to work on your craft. Work on your craft, do your homework, read up on how you can become truly independent so that you own everything, you're in charge of everything, and you know what you're doing and where you need to do it. Because that sounds simple, but it's not.
So are you asking, are you talking about ownership of the rights to your music,
Absolutely.
The lyrics, and the production instead of giving everything away?
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. I write everything. I send everything off for copyright.
Right.
I have a document of ownership for every mm-hmm. single song I write mm-hmm. and release. And I like it like that.
Mm-hmm.
I feel protected.
Yes. It's almost like not letting things go into the wind. You know, sometimes you ever have a song in your head and you never put it down, or a phrase and you said, yes. I should have wrote that down. And a year later, somebody else is using
yes.
it.
Yes.
So in other words, hold on to the things that you have created yourself. Where musicians sometimes are just after the deal, but the deal needs to be about protecting you as the artist and the mm-hmm. songwriter and the producer and arranger and thus and so of
exactly.
a particular song. Yeah.
And being home right now, or just limited right now from performing yes. live and things like that, this is the perfect time to open the books and see how this game is really played. So
yes.
that it doesn't go extinct.
Yes. So let me ask you one more question. What about you and projects? Anything we can look forward to when all of this is done?
Well,
or even 2021. How's that?
2020,
around the corner.
2021, I am looking to do some more work with Nate Banks and Danny Brown out of
yes.
Camden. On their Chase Street show, their little mini series. It's amazing, and I'm so honored that they have one of my songs that I've gifted to them. I wrote it for the show, and that's what I like to do. I love for people to hear my music, and I really want to focus on film,
mm-hmm.
TV, movies, jingles, commercials. Why not? I wanted to go overseas. I just need it to be heard. It feels good. It makes people feel good. And people need that, especially right now. So 2021 has a lot of things. But I know at the top of my list, I have to get to Camden. And I have to get some more music to those guys for their series. I need to get to Houston with Aunt Boogie on his High Volume Music Radio. There are just so many people I'm so grateful for. They've been reaching out to me and telling me, get ready. So that's what I'm doing.
Well, there you are. I think you are a Whittington Steele. Absolutely adore you. Look amazing. Look at her hair. Fantastic.
Thank you. Aww,
beautiful.
Thank you.
You just brought Christmas to us in so many ways. Thank you for joining us.
You're
and listen, everyone, don't forget to give. This is our Christmas
thank
concert,
you.
And we're going to continue. We're going to play a commercial right now, and we're going to get ready for someone very special. I love you. Adore you. God bless you.
Thank
my
you.
Bye. It's just a pleasure to be back with you. Here we are with our Christmas concert for Because Musicians' Lives Do Matter. As we come together during a difficult time, I want to remind you to please give. You'll see below all the ways that you're able to give through Cash App with the dollar sign, Simply Music with the number one, or you can go to the website and go to the donation button and go on simplymusicinc.com. Right now, I got a chance to meet him last night, and I think I've met him many times before because he is such a talent, which is a Winston Gay. He's a guitarist, he's a singer, he's a songwriter, he's an author. He is truly in a class by himself, the author of Monsters Songwriter's Manual and the Monsters Musician's Manual. His latest CD, Simply Wonderfuls, shows his extraordinary talents in many aspects, his vocals, his instrumentation, where he's performed. It's like, you know, you really feel that you're pulled in. And it is my delight to bring to you tonight, this Christmas, as he plays on his guitar, ladies and gentlemen, it's Winston Gay.
Yes, they do. This Christmas. tearing down the mistletoe. I wanna get to know you better. This Christmas, and as we trim the tree, how much fun is gonna be together? Oh yeah! This Christmas, fireside blazing bright, we're caroling through the night, and this Christmas will be a very special Christmas for me. Oh yeah.
Wow, how amazing is that? Winston Gay, everybody's hitting you up, by the way. We have Lisa Chavis, we have Patricia Hawthorne. Everybody's sending you praises about you're one of the best guitar players that they ever heard. And your new CD is entitled Simply Wonderful. Where can anybody purchase this CD? Let us know.
Well, Simply Wonderful actually was recorded last year. And that can be purchased on Spotify and the tributaries of Spotify as well online. Look it up, and I'm sure you know several sites will pop up where you can buy it.
And I just thank you so much for joining us tonight. Any words of wisdom you'd like to share to our audience?
Yes. Don't give up.
Don't give up.
Don't give up.
No matter what.
If you're breathing, there's time. You still got.
We are so excited to have you, Winston. Thank you for the pleasure and my opportunity to meet you one-on-one. And it certainly has been phenomenal. May you continue to be blessed and much success for all of your projects before, now, and the ones coming forth.
Thank you, Mimi. Thank you so much. I appreciate you and your staff. Thank you so much.
Thank you. And thank you to each and every one. Please continue to donate. This is your Christmas concert. Musicians' Lives Matter. And that's the one and the only Winston Gay. As we continue with Tony TNT Jones, he's a bassist. He's also a recording artist and composer. Tony plays the acoustic upright bass. And you don't see too many of those unless you're in an orchestra, as well as the electric bass guitar. He plays jazz, rhythm and blues, funk, blues, and jazz fusion. Performing tonight, Plain But Simple Truth. Ladies and gentlemen, Tony TNT Jones. Thank you. Whoa. That's why they call you TNT. Hey, Tony.
How you doing, darling? Good to see you.
It's so great to see you. So are you. You look amazing. Nancy says hi.
Jean, too. Yeah.
Oh, I know. Jean Karn's coming. Yeah. Jean Karn is next. But let me ask you something, Tony. Your friends are hitting you up. Pamela's saying hi. Douglas said, you killed that. Are you killing it? Nancy. Yeah. Also, your good friend, I wrote him down. I think his name is Rodney Hill.
Yeah.
He's another bassist.
Yeah.
And what people don't really understand that Richard the bass is so vitally. Huh?
Richard Hill.
Richard Hill. Okay, then I wrote it down. His name is Richard Hill. Yeah. People don't always get that the bass is kind of the bottom and makes everything sound really, really good. Yeah. And you play the bass like a guitar, which you can take it to a whole nother level.
I played guitar first, Mimi. I played guitar before the bass.
Oh, really? And so what became your attraction, especially to an upright bass and the electric bass?
Well, I just love music. At the age of five, luckily, I went to E.M. Stanton Elementary School in South Philadelphia. We had a brilliant teacher, music teacher, named Miss Lewis. I'll never forget her. She taught us in kindergarten how to sing, how to play all kinds of instruments, and started us on our way with music. And that's what saved my life, music, because there's a lot of gangs in my neighborhood, and everybody's getting killed and shot. And, I was able to get to the music. Started playing clarinet at the age of four. Stayed in there in the orchestra until finished high school, and just discovered the bass in 12 years old. But I played guitar first.
Well, you know, that's pretty amazing because I know that music is truly healing to each of us in a lot of different ways. And you know, for those that when you feel like you're by yourself, like we're isolated right now. And so what we're doing is, you know, staying at home and we're listening to a lot of music, but people don't realize that musicians and artists and singers are the ones behind the music that they're listening to. And that's why we have all come together. What would you like to say to our audience to encourage them to donate just something?
Okay. For my 5 decades of experience of playing music professionally, I would like to say, if you do the right things, if you treat people good, treat people the way you want to be treated, and you have the right personality. Because there's a lot of great musicians that don't get hired because their personality, you know, the egos or whatever. Keep your egos in check. I would say that, number one. Number two, practice, and make sure you love to practice. Make sure you love to learn. You want to keep learning. And keep playing with as many people as you can, many styles of music. Don't limit yourself. And I've been blessed to play with some of the greatest entertainers in the world, and I'm just blessed.
Well, you certainly are, because your blessings are coming through. Everybody's giving you shout-outs. We're loving you. Thank you, Tony. TNT Jones.
Anybody, don't forget to donate now. Don't forget to donate. It's a very worthy cause, okay?
That's right. Donate. You can go to our website at simplymusic.com. You can do Cash App with the $ Simply Music and the number 1. Let's get ready for the one and only Love You Time. Happy holiday. Jean Karn, she's one of the vocalists that sings like no other that you ever heard. I remember hearing her on Dingy, and I said, what voice is that? Is that like an angel singing, or is it really a human being? That's how beautiful that song captured me. I have been a friend of Jean's for many years and have listened to her and loved her every step of the way. Jean Karn is not only a vocalist with a 5-octave vocal range, but she sings jazz and pop and R&B and soul and disco. She's worked with Norman Connors, Michael Henderson. She's traveled all over the world. She is one of the most talented vocalists with a style of her own. Jean's number 1 hit is Closer Than Close. She would like to share a few words with us. So ladies and gentlemen, my friend, the most beautiful Jean Karn.
Mimi.
Hi, beautiful. How are you, honey?
Happy holiday. I'm wonderful. Just trying to keep warm on this cold Friday.
I know it's a cold Friday. Usually we'll be out on a concert and getting a chance to see you perform somewhere, whether it's here or over in Europe during the holidays. And what would you usually be doing this time of year?
Absolutely. Just like you said. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And getting ready to, you know, to celebrate Christmas with relatives. Although yes, we'll still do that. We'll just do it virtually.
Yeah. And we'll do it virtually. What has this time with the epidemic, the pandemic, and also COVID-19 has affected all of our lives? But what would you like to say to each and every one about the way it has affected musicians?
Oh, my. We have nothing to do except, you know, we can woodshed at home, and that's a good thing. You know, you can practice every day, especially my singers, you know, because I'm a vocal coach and I always urge my singers to sing at least an hour a day.
Really?
Yeah. And singing in the bathroom is so cool because the tile in the bathroom makes you sound echoey.
Mm. Now, so, when you sing closer than close, how do you sing it? Just give me a little bit.
Closer than close, sweeter than sweet, closer, closer, closer.
Oh my goodness, you sound so beautiful, Jean. Do you sing when you cook? Do you cook food?
Oh, I love cooking. Yeah. You love cooking? It's the only way you stay thin. I have to keep on my good food diet.
Yeah, when you eat the good stuff. I remember a song that you did. It was called Don't Let It Go to Your Head. And that song impacted me because it's like people were all about themselves. You know how musicians or DJs are or whatever. You're like all about yourself. And I was like, you know, don't let it go to your head because you still got to work hard. And I learned that from Dr. Perry Johnson. You got to work really hard. So don't think that this moment is going to last. It may not last. You know what I'm saying? So enjoy the moment, but and the song came out, Don't Let It Go to Your Head. And that stuck with me. Please sing a little bit of that for me.
Okay. You know, that was Gamble and Huff, right? That their composition.
Yes.
And little known fact is the fact that I'm singing the backgrounds and they're joining me. So you hear Leon's voice.
Are you serious?
I am so serious. Yeah.
Wow. How's it go, baby?
Oh, let's see. Now that you know how I feel about you. Come on, Mimi.
Don't let it go to your head.
All righty. If you're playing games, oh, it would be a shame. Don't you break my heart. Don't break my heart. And the high, cute things. Ooh, ooh.
You know. After we get done with this year and we go into 2021, what will be coming will be Valentine's Day. You sang that with so many different individuals, with Norman Connors, with Michael Henderson, by yourself. I go and YouTube you, and I've seen you all over the world, especially Europe. I actually love that one because you said, come on, Michael, come on up. And I said, Michael's there.
Yeah, Michael and I work together a lot on every Valentine's. We try to make sure we can, you know, we can get together and give everybody Valentine love.
You know, you have given us so much love and beautiful music, Jean Carne, over the years. What would you like to say to those individuals that really don't understand the plight of the musician going, what they're going through right now? How would you encourage them to donate tonight?
Oh, my. I just wish everyone, you know, would put on their generous hat and go to the site. Let's see now, if you're going to go Cash App, it's $ Simply Music, the number one. And if you're going otherwise, you can hit the donate button at simplymusicinc.com. So I'm urging everybody to be generous. Hi, Karen. I just saw Karen Corbin's name come up.
Isn't that nice?
Yeah. You know, she's manager of Bloodstone.
It's fantastic. I loved her music also.
Oh, yeah.
If you could work with anybody, can I ask you this question? Anybody, past or present, who would it be? Sing, not work with. Sing, because you work with a lot of people. Sing.
Sing with.
Past or present?
Probably Ella Fitzgerald.
Whoa.
Yeah, you know, I met her, and there's a picture out there somewhere. I don't know if we were in New York, but it was at a hall, at a big hall. Might have been Avery Fisher Hall, but a photographer took a picture. She was with Joe Pass, and they were on the Pablo tour. And I of course worshipped her since I could remember. And I was backstage, and she was at the elevator, and I asked her if she'd take a picture with me. And at that point, she had glaucoma, you know, because she was diabetic. And she said, well, I would only take this because of the lights. I usually don't take pictures, but I'm going to take this one with you. And that way I knew she knows who I am, you know. So that just made my life, you know, literally made my life. So Ella, definitely Ella. And there's an Ella Fitzgerald Theater in Newport News, Virginia, where she used to live. And I did their opening about 10 years ago, their grand opening. And there was Ella's 100th last year. I did a concert, you know, at the theater to celebrate Ella Fitzgerald. Wow. La Diva.
We celebrate you. Jean Karn, you stay amazing. You're always beautiful. So that's a natural, looking fantastic and always taking such good care of yourself. Continue to take care of others the way that you do, to enlighten them about music and let them know how important it is. Thank you for being a part of my life and being a part of our Christmas concert tonight. The one and only Jean Karn, I love you.
Love you more.
Yeah, don't forget to donate. That's Jean Karn. And as we continue with our Christmas concert, Musicians' Lives Matter, simplymusicinc.com. Also, you can go with Cash App with $ Simply Music, the number one. We're going to go to a commercial. We'll be right back with more. It's nice to be back with you with the Christmas concert like no other. What else are you going to do on a Friday night? Let us give you some music. We love music. But you never get a chance always to meet the musicians or the singers that are behind the songs. Tonight, we're bringing you some of the best, including Jean Karn. We just saw her with great songs like Closer Than Close and Don't Let It Go to Your Head. But right now, it's Philly's Finest. So we're talking about Alicia Amaro, Denise Amaro, Sandra Brown, Alana Young, lovingly known as Philly's Finest. They were all born and raised in Philadelphia with a great passion and drive to show the world their sweet and loving music. Performing Here Comes Santa, Philly's Finest.
All right. Are you on it?
Mm-hmm. Hello. Hi, how's everyone?
Hi.
You look so beautiful. There's someone that needs to needs to get into the mic right there. Okay, we're ready for you to perform whenever you're ready.
Okay. your words, cause Santa comes tonight. Here comes Santa, here comes Santa, rock down Santa's sleigh. He's got a bag that's filled with toys for boys and girls again. So hear the sleigh bell jingle jangle, what a beautiful sight. So jump in bed and cover your head, cause Santa comes tonight. Here comes Santa, here comes Santa, right down Santa's sleigh. He'll come around the tracks and down this Christmas time.
I also want to thank NABFEME, because when I see all the ladies come together, it reminds me of NABFEME and how they bring women together. How do all of you women come together as a group?
John, do you want to take that
one? We came together as a group. Butch Ingram, he's a producer, and I've worked with him in the past. And yes. So he called me. Asked me did I want to get in a female singing group. Okay. He had Lorna Young in mind. We clicked immediately. Then Lorna knew Alicia and Denise Amaro, and we all fit together so well, Mimi. We just got together and we love each other. We call ourselves sister singers.
Yeah, but I can feel that when you're together on the video, and I can feel it even through here, even though we're virtual, that you're sisters. And as sisters, what has the pandemic and COVID-19 affected you in terms of you getting out to really sing for the people that love you so much?
We can't get out, Mimi. It's very hard. It's very difficult. And we're sad about that. We're upset about that.
Yes, a little bit.
So what can make a difference? Do you think that the donations will help making a difference in some of the lives of the individuals that we need to help? Because musicians' lives do matter. People want to see you.
Yes. Please donate too. This is a worthy cause. A lot of musicians are not working right now, so you know, they need what they can get to take care of their homes and their families. And please wear a mask. Please don't come out without a mask on, you know. Mm-hmm.
And I think what people don't realize, musicians didn't get a stimulus check and all of that kind of stuff, you know. So in other words, musicians really need the help of us helping musicians. And so please donate what you can. Philly's Finest, we absolutely love you and adore you.
Thank you.
You look beautiful.
Thank you.
What kind of I don't care what kind of demic we in. You looking good, girls.
Thank you, Mimi. Right back at you.
And God bless you. And thank you for the beautiful song, Here Comes Santa. And I don't have a chimney brandy. He can climb through the window if he wants to. And bring me my gift. Have a wonderful evening. And thank you for joining us on our concert tonight with Simply Music. God bless you. You know, as we continue with the concert, it's nothing like the music and the artists that we like to bring you tonight, because music has been, as far as I am concerned, the sounds, the music, the artists have really helped my life and develop it in so many different ways as it continues to develop the lives of young adults. And so we like to bring on right now LaVon Donnie Tatum, and an extremely talented, he's a singer, he's a songwriter. Donnie is currently working on his new CD, recording in Society Hill Studio with the multi-talented Butch Ingram. And Donnie is also the founder and CEO of Tatum Music, performing Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas. We'd like to bring you the one, the only, LaVon Donnie Tatum.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening, Donnie.
Please donate and give until it feels good. And while you're at it, follow these rules. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. From now on, our troubles will be miles away. Here we are, as in olden days, happy golden days are yours. Faithful friends who are dear to us, gather near to us once more. Through the year, we all will be together. If the fates allow, why don't you hang a shining star upon the highest mount, and have yourself a merry little Christmas now. I stand in support with some Simply Music Inc. and everybody who put this together to be a blessing to the artists who are on the hard times. Whoa, faithful friends who are dear to us, gather near to us once more. Have yourself merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. Hang a shining star upon the highest mount. right now, right now, right now, now.
Donnie, I love it. Your voice is so amazing, so soothing to us during the holiday time. But I know that throughout the year you perform on a regular basis. So what has COVID-19, the pandemic, how has it affected you? And what would you suggest for other musicians that are, like you, unable to perform on the stages?
I would suggest something that one of the artists before me said, work on your craft. Work on it. It's a time to turn lemons into lemonade, yeah, if you will. Work on your craft. Be creative. Write music. Do whatever. Learn how to take control and ownership of the music that you create, so that when it's time for us to come back out and to be able to show out and show the blessings that God has given to us, we can represent well, and we can take ownership and maybe put a few extra dollars in your pocket that may have been going somewhere else.
Wow.
So we need to do that. Anybody who's listening, if you've seen when I put it up on my pages, I've shared it over and over and over and over again, be a blessing. They're not asking you to give millions of dollars, although they would love to get that. But if you got $5 that you can spare to help somebody be able to eat, somebody be able to keep the heat and lights on and all of that kind of good thing, if you've been blessed enough to be able to make it, and you're not one of those who have fallen less than a paycheck away from ruins, and you do have a few bits. I was always brought up to believe if you got 50 cents and you got some friends and they're down on hard luck, you're supposed to give them a quarter. I mean,
yes, there you go.
It's just the way it is. Mm-hmm. And until we get back to being community, being family, being friends and loving, you know, we will have to continue to do these kinds of things just so that people can survive. So dig deep, give till it feels good. God bless you. Happy holidays to everybody.
Happy holidays, and God bless you too, Donnie. We're going to go to commercial right now. Be right back, and we have more great music as we continue with your Christmas concert right here, Facebook Live. Let's not forget the reason for the season, and it is about the Holy One, and that Christ was born. And Pamela Reese, she's a facilitator. She's also the vocalist and producer and coordinator of Pamela Renee. Pamela, I said your name is Pamela Reese, but it's Pamela Renee when I first started. So let's clarify that one right now, okay? But Pamela, love and adore you. Not only that, you keep entertainment, what we call live. You love to entertain. And tonight we're going to be entertained in a way that can uplift us in a spiritual way, because we don't want to get so lost that we forget where we are grounded from. To hear to perform I Love You, Lord, is Pamela Renee.
Hello, everyone. Thank you, Mimi. Pamela Renee, keeping live entertainment live. I'm going to do a gospel song because Jesus is the reason for the season. Mm-hmm. 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 I love you, Lord, and I lift my voice to worship you, oh my soul. Rejoice, take joy, my King, in what you hear. Let it be a sweet, sweet sound in your ear. I love you, Lord, and I lift my voice to worship you. Oh, my soul, rejoice, take joy, my King, in what you hear. Let it be a sweet, sweet sound in your ear. We exalt thee, we exalt thee, we exalt thee, oh Lord. A child was born, a son was given, he was born on Christmas, Christmas morn. I love you, Lord, and I lift my voice to worship you. Oh, oh my soul, rejoice, take joy, my King, in what you hear. Let it be a sweet, sweet sound in your ear. It's a praise song. We exalt thee, we exalt thee, we exalt thee, oh Lord. A child was born, a son was given, he was born on Christmas, Christmas morn. Oh, we exalt thee, we exalt thee, we exalt thee, oh, 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 oh. A child was born, a son was given, we exalt thee, oh, oh Lord, ooh, oh Lord, oh Lord, exalt thee. We exalt thee. We exalt thee. Oh, oh Lord. A child was born. A son was given. He was born on Christmas, Christmas morn.
I had to catch my breath. Hallelujah, amen. Amen, amen. Do you know how many people are hitting you up right now thanking you?
Wow.
And, you know, for singing, not only the way that you sing, but what it is that you sing. And Pamela, they are really just like loving you every step of the way. It's something that we need to hear sometimes, you know, when you feel a little bit down, you know,
I'm quarantined right now. I need to be lifted up.
That's right. There you go. And may God's blessings continue to heal you in every aspect of your life.
Thank you.
But when we feel lonely and we feel like we're by ourselves, what do? Mm-hmm. We pray and we sing, or we listen to songs and praise about someone that is higher than I.
That's right.
Mighty One. And so you can call it the universe or whatever it is, but we know there is a creator of what that is universal.
Thank you.
And we all can reach him. And you certainly have touched our lives tonight with that one. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Thank you, Mimi.
And God bless you. Continue to donate, everyone. You should see something at the bottom of the page, which is for Cash App, your $ Simply Music One, or you can go to the website at simplymusicinc.com. Reese James is a Philadelphia native.
All right.
You get a chance to meet him. You ready for Reese, Pam?
Yes, that's my boy.
You know Reese?
Yes.
Philly musicians know each other. I'm telling you, you can't get away. Like, you know them. Everybody know Bill Ingram. Everybody know this one. Everyone know that one. It's like we all kind of know each other. It's like a connection of musicians and artists, artistry and producers and those who do give concerts. We're all part of one family that really needs some help right now. So that's why we're giving you this concert tonight. Thank you, Simply Music, for all that you do. And Reese James, Philadelphia native, who's been paving the way, a successful career playing the trumpet in Andrew Hamilton's elementary school's orchestra. He eventually came to realize that his true path lies in song. He acknowledges that he wouldn't be as successful or talented without the love and support of his beautiful mother, Deborah. His music mother, Carol Riddick, who we absolutely love, and also his fifth grade mentor, Robert Taylor, just to name a few. His inspirations are Usher and Luther and Tyrese and Tank and so many more. Now, Reese's proudest moment came in 2018 when he performed for Temple University and signing day in Philadelphia, where he shared the stage with the one and only First Lady, Michelle Obama, alongside the legendary Patti LaBelle, and recently released his new album, I Am Reese, which is available also digital on all digital platforms worldwide, performing Yes, No, We're Ready for You, Reese.
Happy New Year's. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year's to everybody. You see my Christmas gifts in the back. Thank you so much, Mimi. I love and appreciate you. Once again, I go by the name of Reese, and I'm going to do my single Yes and No off of my debut album, I Am Reese. So I want y'all to vibe with me at home, rock with me at home. All right, y'all ready? Let's go. Hey. Y'all ready?
Yes.
All right. Hey. No. Here we go.
I'm gonna have you screaming yes. I'm gonna have you screaming no. I'm gonna have you saying wait. Stop, go deep and go slow. I'm gonna make love to you. You gonna make love to me. I'm gonna give you what you want and what your body really needs.
Hey,
I'm gonna have you screaming yes. I'm gonna have
seconds. Come on. No, I'ma have you saying no, but stop believing, go slow. I'ma make love to you, you gon' make love to me. I'ma give you what you want and what your body needs. We gon' get sexual tonight, your body's the exact right. Wait, let me put my sleeper on, so you can ride on me all night long. Ride me on the bed, ride me on the floor, ride me on the kitchen couch, and ride me on the back porch. First comes off your shirt and bra, then comes off your jean and thongs, and my lips touch on your chest, tongue and kiss till I say yes. Hey, no, I'm gonna go deep, so whoa, I'ma have you screaming yes. Hey, I'ma have you saying stop, go deep and go real slow. I'ma make a lie to you. Come on, y'all. I'ma give you what you want and what your body really. Hey, come on, rock. Hey, hey, hey. Stop, go deep and go real slow. I'ma make a lie to you. Cause I'ma give you what you want and what your body really. The cops are at the door. Neighbors heard you screaming, scratch your screen, feeling for me to give you more. Your body is just tripping, exploding, creaming, dripping. For the work I'm putting in it, baby, I got your body yearning. First comes off your shirt and bra, then comes off your jean and thongs. Then my lips touch on your chest, tongue and kiss to Louis said, I said yes. No, I'm gonna go deep and slow. I say yes. Hey, I'ma have you saying, wait, stop, go deep and go real slow. I'ma make love to you. Cause I'ma give you what you want and what your body really. Hey, hey, I'ma have you screaming. I'ma have you saying, wait, stop, go deep and go real slow. I'ma make love to you. And I'ma give you what you want and what your body really. Say yes. No, I'm gonna go deep and slow. I say yes. Say no, I'ma go so deep and slow. I say yes. No, I'ma have you saying, wait, stop, go deep and go real slow. To you. Hey, I'ma give you what you want and what your body really. Rock. Hey, hey. Hey, 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 I see y'all rocking, rock with me, y'all. Hey, I'ma give you what you want and what your body really.
Whoa, Ree, so nice, so nice, so nice. Your new album is called, and CD, I Am Reese. Where can it be found?
It can be found everywhere: iTunes, Spotify, Google Play, Amazon, Tidal, Pandora. Wherever there is music, I am there. You feel me?
Yes, I feel you. And I thank you. You sound so amazing. I love your new single. I really do. You got me saying yes. You got me saying no. Okay. Reese, have yourself a wonderful holiday. Thank you so, so much for joining us. Listen, everyone,
thank you,
please.
Thank you, Mimi. I love and appreciate you so much.
Oh, God bless you, my brother. God bless you. Please continue to give Simply Music.
Make sure y'all go.
Yeah, go ahead. You tell them.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead. Oh, no, I was about to say, everybody, please make sure y'all go and vote, man. Because I'm going to vote. Go and donate, because we are all donating as well. So we are performing, but we also have donated and are donating. So this is going to a good cause. So please, people, donate, donate, donate. SimplyMusicSync.com or Simply Music One on Cash App. Make sure you put the dollar sign. Donate.
Thank you. Thank you so much. That's Reese. And get his latest on is available on all platforms. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Here we go with Starlene Bay Norman Connors. She's Norman Connors' newest recording artist. If you don't know Norman Connors, I'll tell you a little bit about him. What he is someone who has helped the careers of Phyllis Hyman and Michael Henderson. Jane Karn has worked with Norman Connors. Norman Connors is like a Kenny Gamble, like a Leon Huff. He is a producer, arranger, and he also loves really good talent. And I am so pleased to bring Starling Bay Norman, Connors' newest recording artist. She's jazz, classy, sassy, soulful artist, the Starling Bay Experience. Performing. Mary, did you know?
Hey, hey, hey.
Hi, beauty.
What's up, family? Just want you guys to make sure that you donate. Donate, donate, donate. We need this. Want to let you know this goes from my house to yours. Wishing you all of God's blessings during this holiday season. Yes, hunty. We're gonna do, Mary, did you know? Accompanying me today is Mr. Mark Johnson. Clap it up for Mark. Yes. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you delivered is here to deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm the storm with his hand? Did you know your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Mary, did you know? Oh, did you know? Oh, Mary, Mary, did you know? The blind will see, the deaf will hear, and the dead will live again. The lame will leap, the deaf will speak, the praises of the lame. Mary, did you know that your baby boy was Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day rule the nation? Did you know your baby boy is heaven's perfect land? The little child that you're holding is the great
I am the great I am. I am, oh, the great I am. The great
just want to say thank you for tuning in to DHJ Indie Show. Donate to Simply Music. Give it up to all of the hard workers behind the scenes. When I tell you powerful Black women, I'm saying powerful Black women. Miss Mimi Brown, Miss Andrea M. Jackson, Miss Shauna Williams. Go ahead, Miss Hill. Gotta give it up to the Doris. Miss Doris Hill James. Girl, you put your thing down. Give it up to Shirley Lights and also Miss Pamela Renee for putting all of this together. We thank you. We appreciate you. Happy, happy holidays from me to you. Have a great one and stay safe.
Oh, we love you. It's the Starling Bay Experience. That's Norman Connor's newest recording artist. She does it all, from jazz to gospel, sassy soul. Starling, thank you so much for all the love you gave us tonight. We appreciate you. We love you. Have the best holiday ever. Stay safe and stay beautiful.
Thank you, darling.
You're so welcome. Don't forget to give. This is our Christmas concert. Fundraiser. That's right. It's a fundraiser going on tonight. So give up $1, $5, $10, $100, $50, whatever you want to give. And where you want to give to is right below you, simplymusic.com or Cash App, Simply Music number one. Also, right now we have Kim Miller, recording artist, band leader, guitarist, vocalist for Instant Funk. Got my mind made up. Mm-hmm. Come on, get it. You remember that one? We're ready for Kim Miller, recording artist and band leader, guitarist and vocalist for Instant Funk. Hey. Kim, how are you, Mr. Miller?
Hey, Mimi, how you doing?
I'm so glad to see you because I know Larry from Instant Funk is in Florida. Right. I'm not sure where Johnny is. He's in Florida because I thought he was in Florida, but I didn't know if he moved somewhere else. But I do get a chance to talk to Larry a lot on Facebook and see his gorgeous family. And it's got to be hard for him as well in terms of performing, because when it comes to bands and every artist that we talk to today and beyond, to be on stage or to be in the studio is pretty much all we do.
Yeah, true.
So what has this been for you, and what can you share with us about this experience?
Well, first of all, before I say anything, let me give homage to you, to Doris, and all you ladies who put this thing together today, because this is wonderful, number one. The women of the day are stepping up and doing things. And I just thank you guys for all this. And everybody, don't forget to donate. To answer your question, we stay close to one another. We stay in contact with one another for our strength. And what I mean by that, I mean, like, it's like brothers like Steve Green from Breakwater. Like, yes. He's always putting up a uplifting, like, scripture on Facebook or something like that. You know, because, like, I text, you know, I'm writing back all the time, Steve, I needed to hear this today. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. And, you know, brothers like Sam Peaks, you know, like preaching the words, you know, the word and the rock, Jesus, is the way to get through anything, you know, and this time has been hard for everybody, you know, so, you know, doing things like this is great, because musicians, well, some of us have the tendency to be ashamed when we're in need, or and we're afraid to reach out to let anyone know that, hey, we're having a hard time, you know. But as long as you stay founded and grounded in the word, you know, this too shall pass.
Yes.
You know, and this is where we have to be. Now, like, musically, you know, I have, like, created a lot of different things that I can still do, like a lot of things other than perform live.
Yes.
You know, we are currently, you know, recording a lot of new material, and we're working with a lot of different ways of doing things. And like I heard earlier when T was on, because I talked with T earlier today.
Yeah.
You know, and like, you guys were, when you came on, Doris was talking about shame. Y'all was talking about all this shame and all this kind of stuff. See, I just want to let everybody know. I mean, everybody knows Instant Funk from I Got My Mind Made Up.
Yeah.
But what they don't know is that we are the recording band for Shame.
Oh my goodness, and I didn't know
that. Yes. I mean, Evelyn's first two albums, we did the whole track with T and like Dexter and like Bunny, you know.
Yes,
you know,
yeah.
You know, so, and not only that, is like Butter, you know, God bless his soul.
Yes.
You know, his theme song was Archie Bell's Soul City Walking.
Mm-hmm. Soul City Walker.
Yes, like, which is Instant Funk. We did Archie's whole album. So, I mean, you know, there's a lot of things that we did do, you know, and are still doing. But my words of encouragement to different artists are just to hang in there. And just like T said earlier, you know, hey, you know, this is a good time just to like sharpen your craft up. You know, just take the time to learn what you can. And there's another thing that TNT said that is very true. And, you know, you got to learn how to curb that attitude. You got to be likable. People have to like you in order to want to do something for you. I mean, like, listen, I can't tell you how great musicians have come my way, but I can't use them because of their heads and their attitudes. They were just in the wrong place, whether they're like thinking or the things that they were doing. You know me, listen, if you ain't serving Jesus, I don't know if I could use you, you know, to be, you know, to be honest with you, you know, but, you know, just stay focused and just know that this too shall pass. I mean, this is it, you know, we're in it. You know, but we as Black folks, we have endured hard times for over 400 years, you know, and we know how to go get a peanut butter and jelly sandwich and glass of milk and be happy. We ain't got milk, you know, it's like water, you know, we're fine. You know, we know how to do that, you know, so, but we just have to realize, hey, you know, this is a hard time. We have to help each other. We have to reach out and talk to one another. like I said, like I tried to call Dexter the other day because I call him all the time, you know, and sometimes I can get him, sometimes I can't because he way up in the mountains somewhere and his reception is not that great, you know.
And you know, he's so savvy with the equipment. I guess he has to put on his like astronaut helmet.
Yeah. You know, because you know, it's so funny because he's always calling me and says, "Kim, I got a new song. Can you come up there?" You know, and I'm all for like a road trip. You know, me and my wife will jump in the car. We go up there and just sit up there in the mountains with him. You know, but these are the type of things that keep us grounded, you know, because, you know, you can talk to one another and you can say things to one another that maybe you wouldn't want to say to everybody, you know, and then we find ways to give words of encouragement and strength. And hey, if you need something, if I have it, of course, I'm gonna give it to you.
Yeah.
You know, so. And that's why I say, you know, earlier that what you ladies are doing this evening is so wonderful. And it's like Doris, like I met Doris through T Life, you know, T Life called me, hey, Doris is doing this kind of stuff. And, yeah. And you know, whatever she needs me to do, you know, we're there to help her out, you know, and, you know, and that's just it.
I know for one thing for sure, as I talked about earlier, musicians constantly give. You yes. give to us, you change yes. our lives. Our babies are born. Our relationships yes. are made. Say, when we hear that song, sometimes you might cry because the relationship no longer exists. Or you might be in so much joy because it came together. And it was a beautiful moment. It was your wedding song. It was a song you sang when you dance. It captures a time and a moment. What musicians have given us, we can't even pay you enough for the memories. Yes. If I had to pay for my memories, you know, I wouldn't have enough money. I couldn't borrow enough money for the beautiful memories that musicians constantly give. So what we're asking is very small. Oh, you know, for the talent that God has given you, that you share with your audience willingly. A lot of people don't realize that musicians don't always get paid all the time.
Right.
Your music is out there. Your music is in the atmosphere. You go perform on stage and you don't always get paid. You don't always get paid for the music that you're recorded on. It doesn't always happen the way that people might imagine in their mind. This is an opportunity for those who love music to give back to our brothers and sisters who've been given to us all of our lives.
Yes, ma'am.
And I thank you so much, Kim.
Well, listen, you know, God bless you.
From Archie Bell and the Drills to
We did a couple of things for Gene too, for Gene Card and you know, like Norman and stuff, you know.
Instant Funk has really been the band that was a young band that everybody wanted to use for a number of different songs before you came out with your own music, you know, because everybody was working. That's how you worked as musicians. You happen to know each other and be with each other. And then you got the opportunity to be on. You were on South Soul Records too, weren't you?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Well, yes, that too. But, you know, like the very first thing that we did was with Gamble and Huff. We did the Get Down with the Philly Jump was the very first single, you know, and I was 14. I was 14 when we did that, you know. Mm-hmm. You know, hey, listen, I was 12 when I first started playing out professionally, you know, where I had to go sit in the office of the place during the breaks because I was too young to be in the place, you know.
Yeah, you're like me, sort of.
Yeah.
I wasn't 12, but I was 15.
Right?
Yeah. But I was 15, and by the time I reached the clubs at Just Jazz, I think I was 17 at Just Jazz, and I wasn't supposed to be in there.
You know,
we're just part of the music scene. And when you're a music person, you're part of the music scene because I was writing music, but it wasn't really going anywhere, you know. but I was in a recording studio, just writing. So I understand for you to be able to perform at 12 and 14 years old is pretty phenomenal. Pretty phenomenal.
Listen, I just like to thank you. I wasn't afraid of nothing.
Back then,
but now it's a whole different story.
Now it's a whole different story. Let's mass up. Let's keep together in prayer as I continue to pray for you and your family. We extend our prayers to everyone. What a pleasure to talk to you. Kim Miller, the recording artist, band leader, guitarist, vocalist, and Instant Funk, and so many, many more. You have blessed our lives tonight. Thank you.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. And speaking of Mary, we have Mary Cross. She's an awesome singer, a songwriter, recording artist, and demonstrated in her single, which is called
I'm Out, Hon.
Bye, Babe. In Love, There's a Risk. And when she gets on stage, she just captivates the audience to the point where everybody wants to get up and dance and participate and be all a part of her groove. And it's a nice groove, too. And she makes her performance that is so exciting. Her talent is just as big as her heart. We absolutely love you and we adore you. Performing Who Would Imagine a King? Ladies and gentlemen, Mary Cross.
Hi, everybody.
Hi, Mary.
Hi, how are you?
Great.
Good to be with you.
It's a pleasure to be with you, my lady.
Thank you. We just want you to know that we're honored to be with you this evening. Dale Cottrell is on keyboard, and I hope you guys enjoy it. And please, please do give. It's such a worthy cause.
Mommies and daddies always believe that their little angel is special indeed. How do you want to be? But who imagined a king, a shepherd, a teacher, is what you would be. Who imagined out on the sea, or maybe a carpenter building things. But who can imagine a king? It was so clear when the wise men arrived and the angels were singing your name. The world was stood still to proclaim. One day an angel said quietly that soon
My heart sing. Mary, thank you. Thank you so much. Patrice Hawthorne, so many others are sending you love. They're talking about your amazing voice and how you touch them. You know, in times like this, any other year, all of us would be together somewhere. And you would sing, and Patrice would sing, and, you know, T-Life would do his thing, and everybody do their thing. And then everybody comes together at the end, and they're all together. You're holding hands, and it becomes a big celebration of the holiday. And here we are isolated from one another because of a pandemic. And even though we have three vaccines that are on their way, the second one has just been approved today, and another one is on its way as well, along with the self-kit in another month for us detecting COVID-19. What COVID-19 has done has certainly changed our lives in a completely different way. I have family members that I haven't hugged or touched. And so I have to go to the King a lot.
Come on now.
A lot. I have to go to the King a lot and say, why, what should I do? Calm down, relax, and no matter what happens is what you're supposed to go through. T-Life went through what he went through with his family because I believe he's supposed to tell that story so that we can be aware about COVID-19 and the experience that it has on individuals, because we don't, I know so many people, but everybody doesn't know so many people. So I mean, are they really getting it? And when you sing a song like that, it just brings to heart of where we can be within our hearts. I know that you sing many songs of many different genres, but what would you like to say to our audience tonight?
I would just like to say, everybody, be encouraged, be inspired, find a reason to do something, to give back and to pay forward and to encourage somebody out there. People need. They can't give you hugs. Physically, you can't really do that. But people need to know that you see and you hear them. And above all, you can give words of encouragement. If you can say something kind, if you can even send them a note, if you can send them a text message, let them know you're thinking about them. Because right now, the holiday season tends to be a challenging time for people on average anyway. But if you could just find a way or find it in your heart to take time to not be selfish, but selfless, and spend more of your interest just thinking about how you can make a difference and do something positive and something to make people feel good. That's the main thing about To Inspire You and Mary Cross. I'm not here doing it for fame or for fortune or for any other reason, except I really want to make a difference in the world in some way, shape, or form, so that every place that my feet occupy is better off simply because I passed through, just like you, Mimi. Just like Doris, just like everybody else who has participated tonight, we all have a purpose, and never, ever doubt that.
Amen and amen. Thank you so much, Mary Cross. Continue to be safe. God's blessings upon you, and happy holidays, my dear.
Happy holidays to you, too. Have a great night, everybody.
Thank you. Here we are, Facebook Live with our Christmas concert. It's a fundraiser. You can donate. No gift is too small. We're going to take a short break, and we'll be right back with the one that was behind the success of Billy Paul. Ooh, 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 ooh if you have ever known a person in your life, a man, and you would know for sure. I can say this about very few people. One happens to be Grover Washington Jr. and his wife, Christine. The other one is Blanche Williams. She is the epitome of a strong woman, the manager and author. If you have ever heard the saying, being the wind beneath someone's wings, that had to be penned about Blanche Williams. She was the wife, the helpmate, the motivator, and of course, the wife of the Grammy Award-winning artist, Mr. Billy Paul. I have never, ever in my career have seen Billy Paul without Blanche beside him. I have never seen people go up to Billy Paul without Blanche making sure that it was okay that they approached him. That's what love is about. It's like a one-on-one thing where they were united as one, and there is nothing that anybody could do to tear that apart. It was sealed probably before they even met each other. Alongside Billy Paul, through all of his career, as she's an accomplished writer and all around a great person, Blanche, she's behind an accomplished man, Mr. Billy Paul, when he sings songs like Me and Mrs. Jones and, you know, Thanks for Saving My Life and all these great songs that he does that has changed our lives, Let Him In. And when you hear these songs, he was songs that were a part of a period and a time that influenced us and made us feel good when we wanted to feel like we were in love and made us feel good when we wanted to stand up and be proud of who we are as human beings. So ladies and gentlemen, can I present to you Blanche Williams, the wife of Billy Paul.
Hello, my name is Blanche Williams, and I am the wife of Philly's own, the legendary Mr. Billy Paul. And, you know, if Billy was a Philly guy, he was very much involved in community. He was an activist. And if Billy were here, he'd be the first one in line to do some songs and to encourage you to please donate to this worthy cause. I don't want to forget anything, so I wrote a couple things down. I want to thank you to Simply Music, Inc., to Philly Musicians Lives Matter, and to NABFEME. And to all the people who donated their time and talent to make this event happen. You know, your donations help families in the entertainment industry, shelters, social services. You know, so it's a lot of good causes. And Billy would be the first one encouraging you, please donate what you can, because every dollar helps. Everything helps. So I'm here on behalf of Billy to encourage you, please donate to this worthy cause. And I'd like to wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy Kwanzaa, because I am a woman of a few words.
You are amazing. I'm not sure if you hear me. Do you hear me?
Yes, I hear you.
Oh my, you are just so prolific and so perfect. I was like, did they tape that? Blanche, you stay amazing each and every time. I thank you for what it is that you said, these are things that people didn't know about Billy. Well, you know, we feel as though that he was an activist because of the songs that he sang, you know, but he was definitely a part of the movement. And if he is a part of the movement, so are you part of the movement of making life better for all of us. Thank you for that, Blanche.
Billy marched around Girard College wall as a very young man. He was a civil rights activist. You know, Billy was a jazz singer. Billy wore many different hats. He was an amazing person. But this is not so much about Billy tonight. This is about raising funds for this worthy cause. And please donate, and help some people have a better holiday.
You know, and a better new year and a better tomorrow. You know, Blanche, it just means so much that you are here with us, you know, and happy holiday to you and your family. Thank you for being that strong superwoman. You inspire all of us to be better. Blanche Williams, the wife of Billy Paul, there's only one of you, and we love you.
Thank you. Please donate.
Donate.
Whatever you can, every dollar helps.
Thank you. It really, really does. And that's why we're giving this Christmas concert fundraiser for musicians, because musicians' lives matter. These are musicians from out of Philadelphia. And we're talking Blanche is like Alfie Pollock, you know, and he's a prominent pianist. He created and he's credited with performances with Teddy Pendergrass. And also he's a writer, a composer, a songwriter, a teacher, a mentor. And he's played for so many artists. So we're going to bring him on.
He played for Billy for a while.
Didn't he play for Billy for a while? Oh my gosh, there you go. I mean, we really are a family here, you know? Everybody has worked with everybody at one time or another. And, you know, and Alfie is just a really a nice, nice guy. Yeah. But, you know, Blanche, I love you. I adore you. We all do. Please continue to give and happy holidays.
Thank you. Thank you.
We're going right to commercial. We'll be right back with Mr. Alfie Pollock. Alfie Pollock, there you are. There you are. So amazing and wonderful. Alfie Pollock, as we mentioned, has been on the Teddy Pendergrass album. Alfie is also a composer, an arranger, a songwriter. He's a teacher. He's a mentor. He has played and performed with many, so many artists. And Alfie, I want to say hi to you and welcome you in on Facebook Live with Simply Music. And we'd like to thank Simply Music. We also like to thank each and every one that's been a part of this concert tonight. Now, he will enchant you with a piano selection, Can't We Try? And Christmas just ain't Christmas without the one you love. Thank you. With me, say Teddy Pendergrass, but that's just one of the thousands. I don't know who have you. How many has it been, Alfie?
The Coast Live. You did the interviews with Teddy, the studio stuff.
That's
and
right.
Teddy's band. We did the live, you know,
the live Coast to Coast album.
And also, I've been a guest. And a working guest at the home of Billy Paul and Blanche Williams in L.A.
Yeah, oh, my
and
Billy goodness.
And Norman Connors and I all lived together, hung in Rittenhouse Square together back in the 60s.
Oh, my goodness. Rittenhouse Square is where everybody was. And I think that even members of the Blue Notes, Bernie used to live like not far from Rittenhouse Square and that high rise, which is like supposedly really beautiful. I mean, but you had to be close to the studio too, right? And the studio is right on Broad Street. So Philly International Studio, you're right there on Broad Street. So it's very convenient to be living downtown. But you, with your artistry, when did you start playing like this? I mean, were you young? Were you a younger man or a young boy?
Well, when I got the job with Billy,
yeah,
in 75, they wanted me to be an instant Leon Huff.
Yeah,
so I had to really try to pull that one off.
Whoa!
And, so I'm grateful for all these musicians out here. Sugar Bear, my uncle Sugar Bear Foreman is a person that turned me out into the sound of Philly music. You know.
Yeah.
Whoa.
I know you might be hearing a little bit of feedback because there's kind of a delay. And so if you have something turned on, then you might want to turn down because there is a delay. But I want to ask you, what would you like to say to those musicians out there? This has been a difficult time for all musicians, those that have been the greats of the greats like you and continue to be great, those that are trying to start out and get their music out. Any advice that you'd like to give him?
I've been blessed during the pandemic to be doing Zooms with people around the country.
Yeah.
I've been blessed to have students. I've been teaching piano via Zoom.
Oh, that's good.
Sam Reed, who was Teddy's musical director, and also Georgie Woods' music director at the Uptown Theater. We keep in touch and a lot of musicians call each other. T. Life, Tony Jones, Tony's like my son, you know, and Dexter, and you know, all we just like one family. Richard Hill, the bass player, Alan Nelson, all in all, Melvin the Mervyn Steele's a guy who wrote "Could It Be I'm Falling in Love." You know,
I mean, that's really powerful.
But we need everybody to donate, come out of your pocket, put that money in. Because we, like Norman Connor says, they don't want to, they don't want the musicians to work. We need the money, you know, to survive. You know, because the music is medicine. It's good medicine. Without, imagine the world without music.
I can't imagine the world without music. And for what it is that you've given us, Alfie, you just mean so much to us. Continue to give. Like Alfie said, do not refrain from giving. We have several ways in order for you to give. It's available for you right up there with for your Cash App. You can do $. Go ahead, Alfie. You can speak. You want to say something?
Continue to give. Like Alfie said, do not
refrain. You can say something, Alfie.
Oh, okay. Yeah, thank you very much, Doris. Doris is one of my piano students as well.
What? Go, Doris!
And Russell Tompkins Jr., the stylistics, is one of my piano students.
Oh, my goodness. Okay. A couple people want to give you shout-outs.
It's a blessing. You know, how do all this stuff happen? I don't know.
You know why. Because you're blessed. And you got to be blessed to be a blessing. But Richard Hill gives you a shout-out. Steve Green, Herb Smith, Pete Rudd, Carlos, and
I. Steve said I gave him his first jazz gig.
Yeah, there you go, Alfie. You made greats, you know. Where would they be without you? You have been a blessing. And for the musicians that are out there, please donate right now.
That's right.
With your Cash App with $, Simply Music with the number one, or you can go to simplymusicinc.com. Alfie Pollock, we love you with all our heart. Thank you so much.
Thank you. It's my pleasure.
We're Facebook Live. I'm Mimi Brown of 105.3 WDAS, Philly's best R&B and throwbacks. I will join you tomorrow beginning at 6 p.m. on the Hip Hop Show and with DJ Doc B, then 9 p.m. with Cutmaster Butter, and Best in Your Throwbacks at midnight with Steve Mason. And on Sunday, I do a show called The Comfort Zone, which features Kenny Gamble's wife, Fatima Gamble. I thank her for the wellness of you, because the wellness of you has changed my life. This is part of wellness. This is part of music has always been a part of wellness. Music has always been healing. And one of our healers is you, Angela Burton. She will not be appearing tonight, but her name and her place and the singer Angela Burton has probably been around for as long as we can remember. Angela has opened up for so many singers. We're talking about Club Harlem, and we're talking about she has traveled the world entertaining our soldiers for USO. She has been honored at Kelsey's in Atlantic City and given the key to the city. And we want to be doing a very special tribute to Angela Burton. And so let's do that right now.
Name a place and singer. Angela Burton has probably been there. Angela has opened up for many singers at Club Harlem. She has traveled the world entertaining our soldiers with the USO. She was honored at Kelsey's in Atlantic City and given the key to the city. So no wonder her name is the Queen of Atlantic City, Angela Burton.
Let me tell you a story about the girl next door. She often lives her life like she can get so much more, but it's always on her mind that she's not gonna bring nothing else but her sweet love.
Wow, just amazing. Thank you for that tribute to you, Angela Burton. Thank you for opening so many doors, and thank you for you honoring her tonight. I just like to talk about you, this lady. We got to end with this lady, and that is Shirley Lights. Shirley Lights. Her voice is so empowering and beautiful. Every time that I hear her, whether she's performing live, whether it's on a record or a song, it always just makes me feel good. And that a woman is able to carry a song the way that she does. Shirley Lights, she's not only a singer, but also a producer. She's an international recording artist, has been on West End, Atlantic, Arista, Karmic Power, Midnight Ride Records. She was the band leader. When we think of band leaders, we always think that a man is doing it. We never give the power to a woman or believe that they're able to do it. But the men who understand the power of a woman, they allow her to be in the forefront. And she was the band leader for Mr. Billy Paul until his passing of 2016. She is currently the network director for NABFEME, and that's in the Philadelphia division. I'm proud to be a part of that as well. She is currently has two singles on all digital and streaming platforms from her forthcoming CD, Every Side of Me and Strong Woman, both of which I really, really love. And I love the Strong Woman because I think us as women, we need to hear that. It's all by Shirley Lights. And you need to be a part of the streaming. If you're not a part of streaming, then you're going to miss out on some new music. So make sure you add that to your playlist. Okay. Every Side of Me and Strong Woman right now performing Silent Night. There's only one that can do it tonight, and that is Shirley Lights.
How's everybody doing? Happy holidays. I just want to do a song because this is one of my favorite Christmas songs. I loved it when I was a child. So here it is.
Silent night, holy night, all has come, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child. Holy infant, so tender mild, sleep in heavenly sleep in heavenly.
My goodness. You gave me chills, and I have on a sweatshirt and a sweater. Fake fur. I got chills on my arms. Like, Shirley, what are you doing around here? You sound so beautiful.
Thank you so much.
I know that with you, understanding this really totally, and because you're a part of what's going on right now, the fact that we can have this Christmas concert fundraiser. Yeah, give us some words, my sister.
Well, this is a very critical time in our society, and all over the world, it's global. And I just want people to just hang in there and take one day at a time, and there's going to be light at the end of the tunnel. We just have to hold on. We're resilient people, and we're just going to get through this thing. I want people to mask up.
Yes.
Those are the three M's. Mask up. Make sure you wash your hands.
And maintain your distance.
You saw me go back like that, right? Maintain your distance. We just have to really get through these hard times. And a lot of musicians are struggling. If we can do something to just help make their day a little brighter, that's what we're here for. I'd like to thank my team, Doris Hall James, Shauna Hall Williams, Pamela Renee Smith, Andrea Jackson, Mimi Brown. We put this together. Ladies rock. We did it. Strong women. That's why I have that song called Strong Woman.
Can I hear this a little bit?
Wake up in the morning, bathe the kids, cook the breakfast, and you're off to school. On your clothes and prepare your lunch, and after all of that, go to work too. You come back home from a world that's heavy. She's right there waiting with your dinner ready. All of this can make a girl insane. Never once do you hear complain. She's a strong woman, the kind of never let you down. When life is tough, your friends are gone. She's the only one around. She's a strong woman. She always pulls her weight. She makes something out of nothing with a smile upon her face. That's a little bit.
Shirley, you got to tell us again where your new CD is available with Every Side of Me and Strong Woman.
It's on all streaming platforms, Apple Music, iHeart, iTunes, Amazon, everywhere they stream music, it's there. Support indie artists. And I'd like to thank all the artists that performed this evening, everyone that spoke, everyone. God bless you. Peace and blessings.
Well, Dexter Wanzel just put a message up and he wanted to thank everyone for allowing this to happen and also for recognizing artists. He said, thanks for everyone for putting on this live concert for musicians. Thanks, Mimi, Doris, Shirley, and everyone. He gives us a heart and he gives us a prayer. We love Dexter so much. Cynthia Biggs L, we love her. And we just thank you, Shirley, for being absolutely who you are. Strictly amazing, top notch. And thank you for encouraging. You always encourage me every time I talk to you. It's like, you know, people don't know that, but I want it out into the universe that you are an encourager and that you are here set on a platform above most because you have to help many. And thank you for the many that you helped along the way. Thank you. I love you, Shirley, so much.
Thank you. Love you more.
We're going to go to Doris. She's going to close out for us. Doris Hall James, wow, you are just simply another amazing woman. And maybe you can give us some information that we're going to need. And as we close out tonight of this extremely wonderful Christmas concert fundraiser, Musicians Lives Matter. Thank you for everyone that's been a part of it, for NABFEME and also Simply Music for you being a part. Ladies and gentlemen, Doris Hall James.
Mimi?
Yes, baby.
Mimi, you were fabulous. My heart's full and I want to cry because I'm a cry baby.
Me too. I want to cry too. I'm holding. As soon as we come off of here, I can let it go.
Cry together. I want to say thank you to you. I want to say thank you to everyone for joining in tonight. This has been fantastic. This is a dream that I had for months now, and you guys have helped me to make it a reality. So once again, I want to say thank you. And I want to say thank you to some special friends of mine who always encourage me. They say, Doris, your mind just go, go, go. Do you ever sleep? And I say, no. But I want to say thank you to Butch Ingram. He's always been there for me. When I have a problem, I pick up the phone. Butch helped me out. I want to say thank you to Rena Sinekin. Thank you, Rena. Gilbert Lomax Jr., who has an internet radio station, Philly Live Radio. I want to say thank you to my friend, my friend, T Life. Thank you, T. Thank you, Alfie, for everything you've done. And although these two gentlemen are no longer with us,
They have been very inspirational to me throughout my career. And I want to say thank you to Fat Larry. Thank you, Larry, for everything you've done and all your contributions that you've given to the music industry. And I want to say thank you to Lynn Barry, who gave me my first opportunity to write a song and have it published back there in 1978 called Center City. Thank you, Lynn Barry. Thank you all for all you have done. Simply Music Incorporated, Philadelphia Musician, Lives Matter, DJ Indie Show, NABFEME, and AMJ Entertainment. Thank you all. Thank you all for supporting us this evening. And Mimi, thank you again and again. Happy holiday season to all of you. Be safe and may God bless you. Good night.
Name a place and singer, Angela Burton has probably.
Have a good evening. From our family to yours, mask up, sanitize, and please continue to practice social distancing.